different story. You've likely heard of disorders like Graves' disease, lupus, MS, and rheumatoid arthritis, and they're all autoimmune diseases. Data shows nearly 1 in 10 people worldwide suffer from some type of autoimmune disease. But there's a statistic within that number that may be more alarming. Studies show about 8 out of 10 patients with multiple autoimmune diseases are women. You heard that right, roughly 80%. For some diseases such as lupus, more than 85% of patients are female. And the impacts can be life-changing. Researchers are still trying to pinpoint why women are more likely to have an autoimmune disease. Kenan Smith with our station in Detroit shares some doctors' ideas.
Autoimmune disorders are a set of diseases where the body's immune protections turn inward, attacking tissue and organ.
I'm living with lupus nephritis, which is lupus that affects the kidneys.
Detroiter Camay Wright was first diagnosed with systemic lupus at 13. The diagnosis changed her life.
I have to have a lot of appointments in a lot of different doctors. Like I have rheumatologists, hematologists, nephrologists.
Unfortunately, Camay's experience isn't unique. Autoimmune disorders can affect the entire body.
From our brain all the way down to our toes, we can have that because we have immune system anywhere.
But why is it that the autoimmune system in women is more likely to go into hyperdrive? Dr. Ali Reza Misami says part of it may be hormonal. Autoimmune diseases often emerge or flare around puberty, pregnancy, and menopause. But genes and a woman's 2X chromosomes with an area related to immunity are thought to play a larger role.
Imagine if you have 2X chromosomes, that actually they carry your immune system gene, so you have higher chance of having surge in your immune system.
That immunity surge can lead to any of more than 100 autoimmune diseases, like the joint pain and swelling found in lupus, rheumatoid or psoriatic arthritis, psoriasis and skin issues, thyroid problems responsible for Graves and Hashimoto's disease, and the fatigue and abdominal issues with MS. Since these diseases can affect the entire body, they can be difficult to diagnose.
They are not on top of the differential diagnosis of our primary care or referring physician. So it takes time to actually recognize those patients.
Dr. Misami says it can take years before the classic symptoms emerge in any of these diseases. And that's a major problem since early diagnosis is key.
Most of this disease, unfortunately, can cause major disability, major end organ damage, and sometimes death.
Camay's lupus is well managed. She says working with her medical team and managing her diet and stress allow her to live a fulfilling life despite her diagnosis.
A lot more energy to do things with my family. It's easier for me.
I'm Kenan Smith for Newsy.
Our thanks to Kenan. Rates of autoimmune disease have been steadily climbing over the last 30 years. And among women ages 65 and younger, they've become one of the leading causes of death. Dr. Alex Shikhman is a rheumatologist and is the CEO and founder of the Institute for Specialized Medicine. It is the nation's first clinic for integrative rheumatology. Dr. Shikhman, thank you for being here.
Thanks for inviting me.
So I know you heard in the piece doctors say the significance of autoimmune diseases among women can be due to hormonal reasons. It can be due to genes. What have you found in your work?
I think that both statements are correct. So we do see definitely a difference between the frequency of autoimmune diseases in men and women, primarily in women before the menopause. So, and definitely it's been shown in many publications, and we know this from our clinical practice that, for example, estrogens can facilitate development of some, not all, but some autoimmune diseases. And definitely X chromosome, because remember that males, they have XY chromosome, and women have 2X chromosomes, and definitely X chromosome is longer than Y chromosome. It has much more genetic material, and in part, it carries genetic material which is responsible for immune responses. So that's definitely an issue.
Yeah, on par with what you've seen along with the other doctors we've heard from. You know, we've learned it can take years before patients are able to really spot symptoms. Why is that the case?
Well, it is also well recognized that quite a few autoimmune diseases present in a very non-specific way. For example, patients can suffer from fatigue for a number of years, which may be the first symptom of lupus. Or they may have dryness, which may be the first symptom of Sjögren's syndrome. And they don't pay attention. So I'm dry. So what? But then they start having joint pain and more debilitating symptoms. And finally, they start looking for medical care.
I want to pull up a chart that we saw in Keenan's story. You know, there are more than 100 autoimmune diseases, and you see some of them on your screen, like lupus, Graves' disease, and multiple sclerosis, as we've mentioned. How difficult is it to detect which exact disease someone may be dealing with?
You're talking about semantics. In reality, it's not so important what kind of label you put on a patient, but how to treat the patient, because in real life, we see a lot of overlaps like lupus and Sjögren's syndrome and psoriatic arthritis and ankylosing spondylitis and rheumatoid arthritis with something else. So, but the bottom line is to define what is the underlying immunological problem, what kind of treatment will be appropriate. And in addition to everything else in our practice, we're trying to identify what is the driving force.
My bottom line question for you, doctor, if you can sum it up for us, why are autoimmune disorders more common in women?
Again, there are two things. So number one, hormones, hormones, and hormones again.
Okay.
So number two is probably increased use of birth control pills, especially those which contains high estrogen content, high estrogen level, right?
Yeah.
So number three, women around the menopause, they're trying to stay younger. They're using estrogens, which also known to promote autoimmune diseases. And finally, double X chromosome. So these are main things. Also, if you look at information outside of autoimmune diseases, like infectious diseases, for example, right? So in general, women react to infectious agents much, much stronger than men. And as a byproduct, you develop autoimmune disease, especially in those who are genetically predisposed.
I see. Dr. Alex Shikhman, thank you so much for joining the Y and sharing your insight on this. We really appreciate it.
Thanks a lot.